act, but it was all to no avail. The children have never been seen again. Greece has Sean this weekend. Seems like he can't wait to get back to his mother.
So, you wanna talk a little?
Talk about what?
I don't know, about you, your friends. How things are going.
Nothing special.
What do you say we play together for a while?
I'd rather watch TV.
I wrote a reminder note on the board in the kitchen. Sean's sneezing. I think he's catching a cold.
You've got a cold coming on. I'm gonna see if I can find some medicine for you.
Sean hasn't done his homework yet. It's still early. We'll see about the homework later.
Here, take this. It'll make you feel better.
Thanks, Dad.
Sean, do you want to do your homework now?
Please, Dad, let me watch TV a little while longer. We'll do it later, okay?
I think we should just get right to it. Then it's done and out of the way. Now, get your bag and get set up in the kitchen. I'll help you.
finished. Can I go watch TV?
Let me have a look. Pretty good. Looks like you're done. Off you go.
It's dinner time. I'd better make something for Sean.
Do you want me to get your dinner?
Oh, yeah. I'm really hungry.
Okay, I'll go see what I can find. I'll call you when it's ready.
You can come now, Sean. Your meal is ready.
I'm coming!
It's Sean's bedtime.
How are things at school? Is your teacher nice?
Everything's fine, Dad.
Come on, Sean. It's time for bed.
I'm not tired yet. Can I stay up a little longer?
All right, we'll wait a little before going to bed. But don't say anything to your mother, okay?
Come on, Sean. It's time for bed.
I'm not tired yet. Can I stay up a little longer?
Now, that's not very reasonable, is it? You have school tomorrow. You have to get some sleep.
All right, I'm going. Are you coming with me?
Go brush your teeth and put on your pajamas. I'll come up. Good night, Sean.
My teddy! I haven't got my teddy, Dad!
You must have left it somewhere in the house. Do you have any idea where it could be?
No, Dad. Please, I can't sleep without him.
All right, I'll have a look around and see if I can find it, okay?
Lauren Winter. Ring any bells?
Nope. Can't say it does. Oh, that Lauren Winter. Third floor, last door on the left at the end of the corridor.
Lauren Winter?
Sorry, I only see clients by appointment. It's $50. I don't kiss and I don't do any weird shit.
Fine by me.
Put your money on the table. You got exactly 10 minutes when the alarm rings, it's over, okay? You should take your clothes off. We ain't got all day.
Actually, I'm not a customer.
Ugh, shit, a cop. I should've known. What do you want, a freebie? Is that it?
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. The families of the victims of the Origami Killer asked me to investigate the murders. I came here just to ask you some questions about Johnny.
I already told the police all I know and I have nothing to add. Leave me alone.
The killer is walking around free as we speak. He'll kill again if he's not arrested.
My Johnny's dead, so what difference does it make?
I understand, Lauren. I know what you're going through.
Oh yeah? You know what it feels like to find your own son's body on a wasteland? I'm sorry, I don't believe you have the slightest idea what I'm going through, Mr. Shelby.
I bought 10 minutes of your time, didn't I? All I ask is that you use that time to answer some questions.
You want to pay me to tell you about my son? Is that it? You can buy my body, Mr. Shelby, but my son is not for sale. Get out of here. Get the fuck out!
Well, if you remember anything, the smallest detail, give me a call.
Lauren! Lauren, open up, baby! Me.
Troy, what are you doing here? I already told you, I don't want to see you anymore.
Sorry, Dal, but I really wanted to see you. What do you want, asshole?
Lauren, is everything all right?
She's just swell. Now beat it, loser! You again? If you're looking for trouble, you found it. I'm gonna beat the shit out of you. Oh! Mind your business, asshole.
Oh!
I'll be seeing you, bitch.
Oh. Are you alright?
To tell you the truth, I remember having felt better. Oh. Who was that guy?
An ex-client who thinks he owns me. He was getting violent. I told him I didn't want to see him anymore.
In any case, he packs a good right hook.
Mr. Shelby.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Zone is sectioned off, sir. Please step back.
Agent Norman Jaden, FBI.
You got a badge or something, Mr. Jaden?
Yeah. Yeah, of course.
Check. You can pass.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Blake. Is he around?
I saw him arrive earlier. He's here somewhere.
Thanks. Video memo recording, Agent 47023, Norman Jaden, Tuesday, October 4th, 2011. Time is 8:14 a.m.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Carter Blake. Thanks. Lieutenant Blake, I'm Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI. I went by your office this morning, they told me to be here.
Now, if you're looking for rain, dead bodies, and highways, you come to the right place. Mike, will you tell that asshole with the bulldozer to stop for 5 minutes? I can't hear myself think here.
Right away, Lieutenant.
Well, are you coming, Jaden?
So, what happened?
Some guy taking his dog for a piss found a body about 6 o'clock this morning. We don't know much more right now. Based on what we've seen, looks like the work of the origami killer.
Has the time of death been established?
Based on the rigor mortis, must be less than 6 hours ago. We should know more once the coroner has had a look. Any news on the coroner?
He's on his way, Lieutenant.
We've been waiting for an hour, for fuck's sake.
Has the body been identified?
No, not yet. We should know more later today.
Do we know the cause of death?
There are no marks on the body. Chances are he was drowned, like the others.
Any witnesses?
None yet. Given the neighborhood, I'd be surprised if anybody saw anything. Tony! I don't want to see a single shit-stirring journalist within a mile of here. You got it?
Yes, Lieutenant.
Do you have any leads?
My men are going over to the scene with a fine-tooth comb. If the killer left anything behind, we'll find it. Listen, I'm a little busy here. Why don't we discuss all this a little later, back at the office?
Oh, no problem. I understand. Do you mind if I have a look around?
Be my guest. Hey, Jaden, you come and see me if you find anything, okay? We're on the same team now.
Harry comment, sample of no interest, comes to one of the policemen present on the wasteland.
Some orchid pollen. The concentration of pollen in the air is quickly decreasing because of the rain, but it gets higher in the direction of the body. Harry comment, the victim is lying on his back. No visible signs of violence. An orchid was placed on the victim's chest. A small origami figure in the right hand. Fingers were probably closed after the time of death. Superficial wound on the right thigh. Blood analysis suggests it could be post-mortem. Probably a scratch that occurred when the body was being moved. The blood report indicates an advanced and long-lasting state of exhaustion. The victim is Jeremy Bowles, declared missing 5 days ago. See reference file. His face is covered with mud, like the other victims.